started with week four of part four. You have all done this part so far. You have filled up these rows, made the half double crochet around the edge, and then made these rows here. We'll get started week four, row one. It says chain one, always turn your work. Well, I always make a chain one and then turn, so here's my chain one. Let's get started. One double crochet. Make it up here. So in this double crochet from the previous row. Then you make two double crochets in the chain two space. So that's between the two double crochets. That's number one. And that's number two. Then one front post double crochet around this one. So you put your hook from the front to the back and from the back to the front around the double crochet from the previous row. And you make your double crochet. Now you've got a front post double crochet. I will repeat it again. So you will make two double crochets in a chain one space. Chain two space. That's one. That's the second double crochet. Then a front post double crochet around this double crochet. I'll make it a close up a bit. So you put your hook, yarn around your hook, put your hook through the gap, around the post, up front, up to the front. Put your yarn around your hook and pull it up and finish your double crochet. That's a front post double crochet. Now, this is to be repeated. So two double crochets in chain two space, one front post double crochet. Let's do it again together, one more time. So, two double crochets around the chain two from the previous row. Then one front post double crochet. Yarn around your hook, put your hook through the gap, around the post, up to the front. Yarn around your hook and pull up. Then finish your double crochet. That's to be repeated up until you're at the last double crochet at the end here. And then we will finish it off together. So I almost finished row one. We'll end up together. I made my last front post double crochet. I need to do two more double crochets around the chain two space. So here's number one and number two. And then the pattern says in row one to finish off with one double crochet in the last stitch. Since I made a chain one, I made this one in a chain one space. A chain one that I made to turn my work. So this is how it looks like right now. Front post double crochet and two double crochets in between. Front post double crochets, two double crochets in between. Now row two, chain one and turn your work round. So upside out, inside out, take the wrong side facing you. On top of the double crochet, you make one double crochet. If you rather prefer to chain up three, that's good. But then you start directly in the next two stitches. Then you skip the first stitch. This one you will skip and then you start in these two. I make a chain one to bring up a bit my height of the yarn. And then I make directly a double crochet in top of the double crochet from the previous row. Let's continue. Row two. So there's one double crochet in the next three stitches. So this one, that one and that one. So that means one double crochet on top of the double crochet in the end. Plus one double crochet on top of the two double crochets in the chain two space from the previous row. There. So you've got one, two, three double crochets in a row. Then one back post double crochet. Here you have got the front post double crochet from the previous row. Now you make a back post. So the ribbing will stay on the good side of your work. Wrap the yarn around your hook. Go between the last double crochet you made and the front post double crochet from the previous row. You go from the back to the front. Like this. So from the back to the front. And around that front post double crochet. Up again. Up to the back. So you've got this right now. You pick the front post double crochet up with your crochet hook. Wrap the yarn around and pull through. Now you make your double crochet. See now it's been extended. Front post double crochet is longer. Now it's two on top of each other. Now the two double crochets you make only one double crochet on each. That's one. And that's number two. Here I've got the front post double crochet from the previous row. We'll do the same as we just did. So wrap the yarn around you, go between the last double crochet you made and front post double crochet to the front, from the back to the front, around the front post, up again to the back. Pick up the yarn, pull through and pull through, and finish your double crochet. I'll show you one more time. So it's been extended. Front post, here. Then again, two double crochets, one in each stitch from the previous row. That's one. And number two, I'll show you one more time the back post double crochet. You put it around the front post double crochet from the previous row. So yarn around your hook, you go between the last double crochet previous row and the front post double crochet from the back to the front, and then from the front around that front post double crochet to the back. Pick up your yarn and pull through. Make sure that your hook is facing downwards, not like this, because you won't go through. You will be stuck in the stitches. So up, and then make your double crochet. Show you one more time. Two double crochets, one and number two. In the next back post double crochet around your front post from the previous row. I'll show you how it looks like now. Here. If you have this, you're correct. Repeat this, two double crochets, one back post double crochet up until the end. In the last stitch you will make a normal double crochet. I've almost finished my row. I will show you here. We end off together. I have got three stitches left. I've done my last back post double crochet around the front post from the previous row, and now I'll make three double crochets, so one double crochet of each stitch. That's number two. And since I work with a chain one and turn, I will put my last double crochet in the chain one. Yeah. So this row is finished. I will start off with row number three, chain one and turn. The correct side is facing now. So you see those front post double crochets in your screen, in your work right now. Make one double crochet in the first stitch, just in the next stitch, just this one. If you rather prefer to make a chain three, then add up two more chains before you go. One more chain, sorry. So then you need to add and make four chains here instead of a double crochet. I make my double crochet. And I make a chain one. Skip two stitches, this and that one. Go to the front post double crochet. There you make one front post double crochet. Plus a chain two. And another front post double crochet. So if you move this, have made this one, you put your hook again the same way around and make your next front post double crochet. So you got a little V-shaped stitch above the double crochets, front post double crochets. I'll show you one more time. You skip two stitches, this one and this one. Then we'll make a front post double crochet, chain two, and another front post double crochet around this stitch. So yarn around, put your hook underneath this stitch, pull the yarn up, make your double crochet, chain two, and make another front post double crochet at the same stitch. You've got this. Let's see. This is to be repeated throughout this row up until you're at the end and you have three stitches left. So front post, chain two, and a front post double crochet. Around next front post you make one front post, two double crochets, and a front post double crochet around it. This is how it looks like now. So this to be repeated throughout the row, and we finish off together at the end. I just finished this row up until the last front post double crochet. I made there my one front post double crochet, chain two, and a front post double crochet around the stitch from the previous row. We end off with a chain one. You skip these two stitches, and in the last you will make one double crochet. For me, it is in the chain one, turning chain. So row three has been finished now, and we will start off with row number four. Scroll down, chain one, and always turn all the time with your work. So take the incorrect side facing you. Then we make one double crochet over the next two stitches. So that means one in a double crochet from the previous row and one in a chain one space. So here is my first double crochet. If you rather prefer to chain up three, that's fine. Then make one more chain and one more double crochet in a chain one space from the previous row. Then you have the same amount of stitches. Now it says one back post double crochet around the next stitch. So here's your next stitch. That means it's the second leg of your front post V-shaped stitch. There you make one back post double crochet around the stitch. Like this. Then two double crochets in a chain two space. So you make here one double crochet and another double crochet. Then you're at the second leg from your V-shaped double front post double crochet stitch. There you make two back post double crochets together. Okay, what is that? You have the second leg of your V-shaped front post double crochet and the first leg of the next V-shaped front post double crochet. Those two you will stitch together via a back post double crochet together. So I will show you. Wrap the yarn around your hook. First you make an unfinished back post double crochet around this leg. So put your hook through and around the post up to the back. Pick up your yarn, pull through, and then make an unfinished stitch. You do exactly the same, but then at the next post, yarn around, put your hook through, around that next post, pick up the yarn and pull through, make an unfinished back post double crochet. Now you have three loops on the hook and pull through. That's a two back post together. Back post double crochet together around the next two stitches. Now you start with a repeating pattern. Two chain space from the previous row, you make two double crochets. That's number one, and that's number two. And again, first and the second leg, you must crochet them together, so it's exactly the second leg from the V-shaped back post front post double crochet and the first from the next V-shaped front post double crochet. So wrap the yarn around your hook, pull through the yarn up, and make an unfinished back post double crochet. Wrap the yarn around again and around the next. Pick up the yarn, pull through, and make an unfinished back post double crochet. Now you have three loops on the hook and pull through. Then in this V-shaped front post double crochet stitches in the chain two space, you make two double crochets. That's number one and that's number two. And I will flip my work over to show you how it looks like, for you to figure out what you are doing. See this here? What you have done, first you split it and then you put them together again here. So you make an open V stitch and then you put them together. This is how it looks like. and the next stitch, it will be row, it will be much more visual from what you have done. So since I work only in one color, it's a bit harder, it's harsh to see, but this is what you are doing. Okay, so two double crochets in chain two space and two double crochet, two back post double crochet together. That's to be repeated throughout this row. I will go finish up this row. I will show you one more time what to do. So two double crochets in the chain two space, that's one and that's two. Now one back post unfinished double crochet and around the second leg and back post unfinished double crochet, three loops on the hook and pull the yarn through. That's to be repeated throughout the row and we will finish off together. I've almost finished this row. I will show you how it looks like now. All kind of V-shaped stitches on top of the on the bottom of the front post double crochets. So we'll end off together. I made my last front back post and two back post double crochets together. I make two double crochets in the chain two space. Make one back post double crochet like you have started this row. One double crochet around the chain one space and then one double crochet in top of the last stitch. I've chained one and this is how it looks like right now. So if you have this, you're good to go. Let's get started with the next row. That will be row number 5. Chain one and turn your work, it says, and then one double crochet over all the stitches throughout this row. So let's get started. If you like to make a straight chain three, that's fine, then skip this stitch and start directly in the next double crochet. Since I make a one double crochet, one chain, I will make my one double crochet at the same place. So like this, and now you will double crochet throughout this row. And here and there the next. See, all double crochets in top of the double crochet or the two double crochet back post together. Two back post double crochets together, sorry, you all make one double crochet in top of them. So keep on going and we'll end off this row together. So this is how it looks like. So this is how it looks like when row 5 has been finished. All